Good morning, everybody. It's Peter Simmons coming to you with our program. My screen's over here. Sorry, I keep looking back and forth, but that's the nature of the game here. So this is going to go live on Facebook and YouTube, and then I'm going to record it and send it to you. So what this is my training video on how to sell video, web, and media service to corporations and add $5,000 to $5 million to your revenue and end the cash flow problem. So, who is this for? This program is for filmmakers, YouTube channel experts, media producers, and all of those people have a problem that I have solved. Getting the revenue you need to create positive cash flow and build your dreams. So I'm excited to bring you this training today. So help is here. This video, you're going to get the answers that you need, and it's going to be recorded, as I mentioned. It'll be at SimmonsGalleria.com. So here's what I wanted to tell you about. What I'm going to teach you today is creating your first impression. How do you create a first impression with corporations? I'm talking about small companies, a local pizza shop you want to do a commercial for, up to global companies. We'll be talking about how you create a first presentation. Secondly, what's your market? What market are you in? How to research that market? Oh, here's a great one, the big SEC secret I'll be teaching you later. How to find their budget, how to get them to tell you their budget, how to pitch the project, how to do your proposal, how to close the deal. Oh, very important, the secret to the gatekeeper. This was something I found after 5, 10 years of selling to corporations. This is fabulous. Figuring out what they actually want, which may be different than what they say they want. How to get them to buy, making your offer irresistible, and how to close the deal. So let's get started. So thanks, everybody. My name's Peter Simmons. You can read about me on my website, but I got a degree in communications, taught film at Concord Academy and other schools. I won an award with George Lucas, who made Star Wars, built a film business, and here's the part's important to you. I sold and produced $10 million worth of revenue for my projects, created marketing plans and media plans for small and large companies in 80 countries. And a little fun fact, my Aunt Eleanor was the voice of Maleficent in the Disney films. So here are some of my clients. I won, as I mentioned, an honorable award with George Lucas, an architectural award in New York City, an award in Germany, gold, silver, platinum awards in Boston. I won an honorable mention in the San Francisco International Film Festival. But along the way, I was selling media to big and large corporations, some of them listed on your screen: Addison Wesley, Agfa, Gillette, Polaroid, Chubb Life America, Kodak, Braun, Seagram's, IBM, Star Wars. I did the introduction to the Star Wars lunchbox when Star Wars came out. So it was all pretty exciting, and I'm going to teach you a lot about how to sell to corporations in this presentation, but I'm not going to be mentioning their names associated with a specific project because it's mostly confidential, but you can see on my YouTube channel excerpts from a lot of these videos. So my big mistake, I traveled the globe for one of my clients, put the entire travel expenditure on a credit card, which I would not advise doing. I would advise working your cash flow so you don't have to do that. The corporate invoice went in for the travel, took 60 days to pay me. And by that time, I needed the income because my cash flow was off because of this tremendous expense in the travel. And the money came in, almost lost my house. 2001, the terrorist attacks caused the first major financial upheaval. In 2008, again, with a financial meltdown, got into trouble. So you are going to benefit from my mistakes because I'm going to teach you what I learned so you won't do the same thing. So, oh, Now, if your dream is to create an independent feature, do some music videos you love, produce that great documentary, I have a workshop for you. This little commercial in the middle of my presentation, and that is getting the funding for your project. Now, I got $25,000 for a pilot, $30,000 to write a movie script. I'm currently funding an independent feature at $900,000. So I'm running a 12-week live workshop for you to teach you everything you need to know about how to do that. And the list of what you're going to get is right up there on the screen, so I won't go through it now. So let's get back to the training for today. So the first thing you have to do is create a great first impression. Now, here's how you do that. Your website has to be impeccable, has to be beautiful. Get other people to give you feedback. Don't trust your own judgment because many times you think something looks great and the other people won't. Your social media has to be very good, and don't mix a lot of silly stuff like I did into your social media. You want it to be clean and look great and present you in the highest light. Your portfolio has to be great. Now, this is a very important point because your portfolio has to be great for your market. So if you're presenting to small businesses in your local area to do TV commercials, you can have great TV commercials. If you don't have one, do one for a super cut rate price or pro bono for a local restaurant or whatever, and put it on your website. But it's got to be your best work. And again, you can email me. I'm going to give you my information later to find out how your stuff looks. But put your best stuff up there. Then I say here, dress for the client. What I mean by that is you have to address your dressing and connecting to connect with that specific demographic, that person. If you're going to a bank, you got to be a little banker-like in your look. If you're going to meet with a rock and roll artist about a music video, you kind of want to look a little more like that. You see what I'm saying? So we'll go over that in my workshop I'm going to tell you about later. So what is your market? Now, in order to consider what your market is, you have to look at what's your background, what's your training, what's your skills, where did you come from? And I'll be able to tell you in my live workshop exactly who that is that you can appeal to. And it's not what you think it is. Okay? If you're working for a nonprofit trying to raise money with your films for a fundraising event, you think you have to come across a certain way, but you may be wrong because the funders may be someone else. And as I mentioned, you've got to consider your portfolio and your connections. Now, people think they're not well connected, but it's not true. Because forever this, you've heard of the 7 degrees of separation or whatever that is. Well, that's true because you may know somebody who owns the pizza shop down the street, but they may know someone in Hollywood and they may know someone at IBM who'll let you in the door. But I'm going to teach you how to get in the door with no connections. So you don't have to have any connections. You can sell video to any size corporation with no connections. But then one of the reasons I'm doing this training is because I'm very excited about the potential for changing the world that you have, because the media is tremendously powerful. I learned this over my career. I would make videos that would raise $100,000 in one morning. I'd make videos that would put a global corporation on the map. And of course, we can bring about social change and help with the climate problem and all these things through video. So honesty, integrity, and truth, beauty, and power is what I'm standing for you. That's why I'm offering this training. So then the next thing you got to do is research your target client. So let's say you want to do videos for hospitals. It's a really good market in your area. You want to get into hospitals and get them. We have to research them. Now, how do you research them? This is what I learned over 30 years of doing this. So one way you do it is you study their website. That's pretty obvious, but you'll be amazed how people don't think about that. The next skill you're going to learn is how to ask the gatekeeper, the corporate executives at the small, medium, and large size companies. They have a gatekeeper, which means someone is assigned to keep salespeople away. and you either have a salesperson or you are the salesperson, and you're the media producer, web, video, photography, no matter what it is. So they're there to keep you out. Well, so what you want to do is align yourself with them and make them your partner. We're going to go over that in great detail later. And at my video-based and live workshops, I'm going to teach you a lot of details about that. Then you got to read their brochures if they have them. Many people still have brochures, and that's good. Sometimes they're very beautiful, got a lot of meaning. You can also talk to their vendors. A lot of time, the vendors will know a lot about what they're doing and what they're up to. Now then, in my workshop and later on in this particular video, I'm going to teach you about the Securities and Exchange Commission secret information that you can get access to, which will tell you what the company's problem is if they're a publicly traded company. And I've got research techniques to find out what their problem is if they're not. And most companies you'll be dealing with are not publicly traded. But if you want to do the publicly traded company, you can do it. And then, of course, you want to find out what their problem is, you ask the client. I'm going to teach you how to do that. And they will tell you. And here's an interesting thing I learned over many years selling to corporations. They will tell you first. So let's say they want a video to present a product on the website. And you say, why are you doing the video? The first thing they say will be the most important and powerful thing to them. Okay, the budget. Now, this is a very important aspect. As you know, I made some serious budgeting mistakes, which I'm going to go over in my workshop. But you got to budget properly. Your sales flow will depend and help the budget. And I'm going to teach you a way to find out their budget. I call it the house analogy. So listen to this. So they say, we want a marketing video to present our company in the best light. It's going to look beautiful. It's going to go on our website. We're going to email it to people. It's going to be on our YouTube channel. We want you to make it. And you say, well, what kind of budget range did you have in mind? And they say, well, what would it cost to do a 10-minute video? Well, so here's what I say, and this is very powerful. So I say to them, well, it varies depending on the elements of your budget. Like, for example, imagine you're going to build a house. You want a house in the coast of Maine on the ocean. How much will that cost? And the client will immediately see, well, you got to know what kind of house it is. How many bedrooms? Does it have how many bathrooms? Does it have a patio? Does it have a sunroom? Does it have this kind of roof or that kind of roof? How far is it from the water? 20 feet or 2 miles? All these factors. So you ask them. So videos like this, the budget ranges around 12,000 to, it can go up to 250,000. What do you think your budget aligns with here? Many, many times, almost always, they would tell me, because they have a marketing department, a salespeople, a VP of marketing, a CEO who've got a budget for this. So they're going to say, well, we budgeted $30,000 for this. And you can say, well, that seems reasonable. Let me work on that. Now you have some guidelines. You want to work at your appropriate rate. You want to get the right amount for shooting, for editing, for all the factors that get in it. But you need a window with which to work, and that's how to get it. You ask them. So how to pitch. How do you pitch your proposal to them? Well, first of all, you have to get to the actual problem. Because what you're doing, you may think you're producing a website. You may think you're doing a photo shoot. You may think you're producing their YouTube video. You may think you're doing their product launch. But what you're, and you're doing all those things, but what you're actually doing is solving a problem. And that's what you have to ask about. Why is this being done? What's the underlying problem? Because I found many times, no matter how big the company, if it's a Fortune 500 company, many times the VP of marketing was off the mark. Now, why is that? Because they're myopic. They're looking from inside the company. And they see all their problems, and they see the budgets, and they may be missing the most obvious thing there is. So ask them, what problem is this video trying to solve? Now, then you can see on your screen, I have the word listen. So I put that word on the screen three times. Listen, listen, listen. Because I noticed when I was doing a sale and working with a client who told me their budget or didn't tell me their budget, I was listening differently than normal. I put on this listening hat that was very powerful, and I would pay careful attention to what they were saying and maybe what they were not saying. I'll give you an example. I went to a client, a computer company, and a guy was telling me he wanted this video for human resources in order to make a great impression on new hires. He had done a video earlier that didn't quite hit the mark, so his boss and even his wife at home were upset that this didn't hit the mark. So what he really was doing was making the video to serve a good purpose, but he was proving himself to the company. That happened actually many times. And when I made a beautiful video, he or she became a hero. So keep that in mind. So the client will tell you the problem and usually first, but I'm going to go into great detail on this in my workshop. You'll find out about it at the end if you stick around. So the proposal. Now, once you find out the problem, you've built a relationship, take the time to build the relationship. Help this person know, like, and trust you. That's why it's important to know who your market is, what kind of people you're going to approach, what are your best skills. If you're a powerful musician and music-oriented companies might be great for you. If you got a great voice and you do voiceovers, then a TV companies might be, you know, you got to kind of find your niche, and I help you do that in my workshops. So as you can see on your screen, the proposal solves a series of problems. It's what you give them at the proper point, when they're ready, when they've sold you the problem, when they're ready to buy, and they'll tell you. For instance, my previous example, they need a new corporate video. They got $30,000 budget. Well, when are you launching that? Oh, we're launching that in the spring. Well, now you know when they need it. So you're going to follow up with them pretty quickly because they got to get budget approval and get it going before the production. So on the screen, you can see the elements of the proposal. I won't go over them now, but you're going to get that as a template. But you got the executive summary with the problem solution and your expertise, the proposal with objectives, the process, the schedule, the budget. I'm going to give you a template for that. The summary, the benefits, testimonials, and references, and then don't forget a contract to sign. And you can find them online, really good contracts, but you want to look at them carefully. Oh, and if you need, I deal with freelancers, independents, or I deal with small companies or large companies teaching them how to do this. But if you need legal advice and contracts, there's a wonderful service for anyone, freelancer, you can get monthly. Message me about that. So, closing the deal, okay? Now, so you've got the proposal, you've given it to them, they love what you have to say, they like you, they like your work, they like the solution. That's what's inspiring them to buy. They're not all enamored of your videos, although they might like them a lot, they might like you a lot, but really what they're buying is the solution to their problem. They're going to look good. It's going to make their ego soar. It's going to help their company make money. It's going to help launch this new product. It's going to turn around the HR. One video I did was helping to recruit nurses because I did it for a hospital. They were having trouble getting nurses. It was during a nurse shortage, and they were driving nurses to the interviews in a limousine. That's how much they needed. So their goal was to have this video bring on nurses, and I knew how to do that. So very important to do that. So here's how you close the deal. So you presented it. You asked the magic question, which again, in the workshop, I'm going to go into more detail on this. But the magic question is, they've seen the proposal, they've seen your work, you've solved their problem, you've told them how you're going to solve the problem. Your closing question is, what did you like best about what you saw? The reason that's such a magical question is you're not saying, so what do you think? And then their answer is going to be, well, the third part of the proposal where you're talking about the benefits, I'm not sure that's going to work. I don't know if the CEO will like that title, and they'll come up with all their negatives. But if you say, what did you like best about what you saw? They're going to think about what they liked best. And when they think about what they like best, they're going to share it with you and you're going to know how to move them forward. So you let them talk as much as they want because they're sharing all of their feedback with you. What they don't like, what they do like, budget issues, anything, the schedule. And you listen, and I always took notes because it helps me listen better and then I can refer to it later. But I'm very discreet. I got a pad of paper. I'm looking at them, talking to them. Okay, then you ask questions to get at the root of what they're talking about. And then there's the whole role of overcoming objections. You've heard of this in sales. Well, sales is a misnomer because you're not actually selling. I know many of you don't like selling, but what you're really doing is creating a win-win. When you get the project, you'll have new revenue. You'll be able to complete your project and do a great job. When they get the solution, they win because they solve their problem. They look good, whatever their issues are. So you're really creating a win-win. So get rid of this convincing selling paradigm. It doesn't serve you. However, when they raise their big objection, which they may do, you got to handle the objection. So I'm going to teach you more about this in the workshop. But for now, let me tell you what you do. It's right here on the screen. Whatever their objection, the budget's a little high. I was hoping to spend $25,000. Here's the answer. That's exactly what I thought. But I did some research, and what I found out is in order to get the animated part you need and have it look really great, it came in at $30,000. And let me tell you, I'm hoping you'll be able to do that. Well, yeah, and then they'll come around. It's quite amazing. And again, integrity, truth, and honesty is your partner. Because if you sell yourself short, which I did many times, you'll lose money on the project. You won't be able to complete it well. So you got to be careful of that. You want to budget properly. That's why this sales and social media and web presence is so important, because you got to keep the pipeline full of projects, okay? So the closing question, here's the closing question. So they've looked at it, they like the budget, they got to make a decision soon. You've laid everything out, you've answered their questions, they seem to agree. The closing question is on the screen. So would you like to get started? Or would you like to know what the next step is? Here's the contract, would be the answer. So those are closing questions. Now, this I learned after many, many years of struggling with this closing. Because you want them to sign up, you solve the problem, it's a great problem. You ask the question, so would you like to get started? This is a hard thing to do, but it's very simple. Stop talking. There'll be an uncomfortable, if they want to go ahead, they'll say, yeah, I'm ready to go. But if they have to think about it, even for a minute, that minute will seem like an hour. If they need to think for 3 minutes, seem like an hour and a half. But just sit quietly, just relax and wait. Because the adage goes, whoever speaks first, well, the loses is the word, but it's not a loss for them. They win, they get your project. So if they speak first, they go with the deal. If you speak first, their train of thought. You're uncomfortable and you want to say, well, you know, I understand your budget was a little high. And no, that stops them. You want to let them mull it over and come to a decision. No matter what they say is fine. Yes, I'd love to get started with you. Well, I really need to see another proposal with this in it. Then the next time you do the same thing, you just stop talking. It took me a long time to learn this, but it's very powerful. So the gatekeeper secret, I told you I'd tell you about this. There's going to be more in the workshop, but basically you get them on your team. And I'm going to have a template for you at the end about this, because they know the buyer, they speak to the buyer, They know the schedule of the buyer, and their job is to keep the salespeople out. The VP of marketing has told them, "I don't want to talk to any salespeople trying to sell me something. You're not a salesperson, you're a problem solver, and you get to know the gatekeeper and become their partner." It's very powerful. And I'm going to show you that at the end here. So, what are your revenue goals? How much media do you want to sell? You're a freelancer, you're a freelance web developer, you're a freelance photographer, you're a freelance video producer. You're a small company, 2 to 3 people. You're a medium-sized company for video and production of 5 to 20 people. What is your revenue goal? How much do you want to sell in 6 months, 1 year, 5 years? Write it down, send it to me. There's my website, simmonsgalleria.com. It's on the screen. Send me your goals. I'd like to hear from you. I like to hear from my clients and business partners. I'll tell you why in a minute. So, what is your why? That's very important. I know you've heard it 1,000 times. Is it the money? Do you want the money? Do you want to fulfill your dreams? Do you want more time? Do you want to do your big independent project? If you do, go to fundingfilmvideo.com where I offer my workshop, which is a live workshop that will get you from I need $15,000 to make my music video to knowing exactly how to get it. There are 15 to 20 different routes that I teach you. Corporate sponsors, approaching individual investors, special secret programs that I learned over the years from video partners, TV producers, and major motion picture executives. And then I have there also my free $15,000 bonus plan template where you get for free a program that shows you how to get $15,000 locally to produce any film you want in pure profit. So it's very exciting. So, what are your roadblocks? Unfortunately, it's the biggest one is your attitude and your limiting beliefs. I know this because I've been doing this for decades, okay? And I can help you with that. In my workshops, I'm going to work on that and help you. One of the tools I've found that helps a lot is Wu Wei Wisdom, a coach, a Taoist coach out of England, who teaches do not compare, criticize, or judge yourself or others. Don't compare yourself with whoever your big hero is. You know, keep them your hero and get inspired by them, but don't compare yourself and feel less than. Then there's your team, if you have one. I work with a lot of independent producers. That's what I did for many, many years. Then I built a company, sold 10 million in revenue. So your team, your skills. Be honest with yourself about your skills. Tell me your skills. Book a Zoom together. We can go over your skills. You got to be honest about your skills because your skills are marketable. I don't care what they are. Okay. Your presentation and the money. That's why I'm doing this, because of the money. So I hope you got value from this. Let me know. Send my team a message. Go look at Funding Film Video. And I have an offer for you. I got a complete online course going into much more detail. I'll tell you about in a minute. It's very clear, very concise, video-based with templates. It's easy to follow with videos and a workbook. And you can reach out to me anytime through my Facebook group, through direct messaging me or someone on my team, through my website. So work with me, get in my Facebook group, contact me. I'd like to look at your portfolio and your website, okay? So what you get in the 10-week workshop, the 10-part workshop, excuse me, the 10-part workshop is a $2,500 course. There's also a workbook that's $197, sales template $697, a lot of details about what you learned today. I like to work with videos and information sheets. I know that the media people like those and work well with them. Some proposal samples for TV, film productions, corporate videos, SEC secret program. These are ebooks and videos. $197, $197. Those are the retail prices. Oh, my research template, how to do that research I mentioned. Budget guidelines, another $197. The gatekeeper template. This is the best thing you're going to. You are not going to believe this. Because everyone has a gatekeeper, even the owner of the pizza shop at your corner, or the guy at the front who's welcoming the customers. When you say, I'd like to see the owner, the sales flag goes off in their head. Oh, this is a salesperson. And what were you interested in? You know, they're trying to avoid salespeople. So you've got to get through the gatekeeper. I teach you everything about the closing template. We went over some of that. So here's everything you get in my course, the 10-session workbook templates, everything you need. Start selling to local restaurants, theme parks, to middle-sized companies, small businesses, million-dollar companies, $30 million companies, $100 million companies, or global Fortune 500 companies. You may not think you can do that. I didn't think I could do that. Then I closed a deal for $500,000 with a global corporation because I knew how to do this. So the total value of this package you're going to get is $4,676. But I'm offering you a special deal because that's what media producers do on webinars and live shows like this on Facebook and YouTube. Why am I giving you a spectacular deal? I'm giving it because I want to share the hard lessons I've learned. And you are the future. I believe in media. I believe we can change the world through truth, honesty, beauty, and joy, and you're bringing the best products and technology to the market, okay? So again, what you get is on the screen, that's your list, $675 total price for the whole 10 modules with all the templates, all the workshops. That was what was approved by the team, okay? That's a very, very good price. But I decided for 2 weeks while this video is being released for the training, it's $297 for everything you saw. And so you want to go to my URL that you saw, you see now on your screen. I'm going to put it up there. So here's the deal. For 2 weeks from today, I'm going to be putting this live on YouTube and Facebook, recording it. And then for 2 weeks from today, I'm going to put this out at $297 for everything you saw. So go to the URL on your screen that'll link you to the buying page, put in your order, and message me directly. I'd love to work with you. So thanks so much. So why am I doing this? I'm doing this because you are the future. You have the power to make the world a better place, solve the world's problems. You can do it and I can help. I learned this when I made videos that help build hospitals, help create new technologies around the world. In one of my videos for Agfa Corporation, I can mention their name because I'm not giving away any of their secrets, for Agfa Corporation, they were involved in a digital printing revolution worldwide. I made a whole series of videos for them and that changed the world. And I made videos that built homeless, changed the world. You can do that too. So I'm here to help you every step of the way. Go to my website, it's on your screen. Get look at this course, look at the workshop. Look at the workshop for funding your independent features, music, videos, and documentaries. Again, thanks so much. Look forward to seeing you at the next workshop. Thank you.